Dried blood streaks the floor in a wide swath as if someone had been dragged or slowly crawled away. It is hard to tell whether it came from or went towards the infirmary door. So,
hello?
A heavy metal door stands unmoving, occasionally emitting a mechanical hum as the servos and motors attempt to futilely move it to open. Excuse me. Alright. Now that we've healed up our character.
Is anyone there?
What I wanted to do, go away. With a fine layer of dust and leaking oil underneath, the loader appears to have been unused for a long time.
This isn't gonna work.
Eligible notes on these scattered pieces of paper indicate the author must have been a doctor or a scientist. Floor lighting seems standard for this level. The information terminal reads, code 5448, level lockdown.
Security lockdown? Must be why there's nobody here. Maybe they were evacuated. Empty. Fuck, I just... Where the hell is everyone?
Doctor, where are you?
Tell us something you don't know.
My dear little girl, you don't know how happy we are to have you with us.
A bright red wall-mounted box that reads, in case of emergency, break glass. A note inside the empty emergency box reads, due to budget cuts, the fire axe has been replaced with this note. Have a nice day.
Damn it. Cut myself. This is short.
We've got delivery systems, and we need you to combine them in interesting ways. Can ballistics be used?
Notice. Maintenance doors unlocked. Lock will be engaged in 3 hours.
The radio is set to auto scan, picking up various transmissions.
Link has experienced an electrical failure in the nuclear fusion fission hybrid engines.
Standard metal sink caked in soap and dirt. A filthy wet towel plugs the hole of the toilet.
This is disgusting.
A surprisingly clean toilet bowl.
Good to know the important stuff keeps on working.
Wait a minute, what did that say? I aim to keep this bathroom clean. Your aim will help.
Eat for free between 1 and 2 a.m. at Tenta's Room Lake. Tell them your friend Phil sent you. Tenta's meat that almost tastes real. Yum, yum, yummy, yum. Tenta's.
What the fuck? That radio is creepy. Fucking. Every time we come into this room, it changes. Alright. Now that we've done opened up the maintenance room, now we need to move.
Warning. Air filtration system offline. Toxicity increasing to dangerous level.
It's stuck. Come on, old man.
He needs the toilet.
There you go.
Alright. Now that we've stopped up the filtration system,
the smell. It's sweet.
Andrew Bryan, Engineer, Level 1. Andrew here. It's about 6 a.m. I'm absolutely exhausted, so this is the most advanced scientific research ship in existence, huh? Bullshit. I've been here for only 3 months, and I know why the previous guy quit. leisure equipment, steam vents, circuit breakers, everything has at least one serious design flaw. Not only are the coolant systems capable of failing, they're capable of at least four different types of fault. And I can only spot two of them in advance. This ship's been running for 50 years, and nobody bothered to do any upgrades. Bottom line, the casings are shoddy and they're going to need months of work to make them 100% safe. I also pulled a muscle in my shoulder trying to rotate that pressure release valve. The bastard needs to be turned three goddamn times. Andrew Bryan, engineer, level 1 again. So this is his PDA, and he's just writing a journal. Simon's volunteered to be a research subject, and something has been off with him since he got back from the labs. I don't want to report him to security, but I'll keep an eye on him. Fucking research departments. Can't they use monkeys like everyone else? D-Sec sent me down to the ass end of the ship to fix the fluid storage vats. Again, not too long ago, other vats malfunctioned and started spraying that acidic shit all over the place. The bulkhead's locked down, and the entire maintenance crew dissolved. They only found teeth. I'm not going home in a jar, so I've killed the security system lockdown. If that thing so much as pisses that acid in my direction, the system will reset all the security procedures. Safety first. Alright, so that's how we end the lockdown. We use this little nifty drill we've got in here. And then we walk away, and then it starts pissing acid.
Attention. System rebooted. Air scrubbers activated.
Finally, some good news.
That was probably one of the most dangerous things you could have done. You should have, like, put the thing on a pole because it wouldn't have waited to start spraying out. All that acid would have just went everywhere. You don't drill a hole and then 5 seconds later the acid starts coming out. Alright, now that we've ended the lockdown, we can go to basically where I stopped. Alright, we'll go down a floor.
Attention. Product storage 2. Access to product storage 2 is denied until further notice.
That's fucking creepy. I don't know if you guys can hear that. That's like whispering and a child giggling. Safety music elevator. Doo-dah, doo-dah. I'm going down a floor. La-di-doo-dee-dee. Seems like the sounds are randomly generated as well.
Attention, service platform 1. Please check in with the duty officer before engaging with any products.
Echo. Dirt cakes the inside of the glass. Spirit blood makes it impossible to see into the room beyond.
Security holograms are still working.
The two child-sized body bags lie very close to one another as if for warmth.
Do something like this. Oh god. I need to get to Rebecca. I'm so sorry. I'm so, so sorry.
I picked up an electronic toe tag. Claire Daniels, general nurse. I've never read this. I did not want to go delve too much into the creepiness, but I did see that, which is why I didn't respond. The first time it scared the literal shit out of me because I had my headset up really loud. When Mike suggested I go and work in product storage, I honestly thought he was nuts. I mean, the pay is great, and the hours are fantastic, but the job, well, I think it'll be boring. Apparently the only time a nurse is ever needed is when they crack a stasis tube open, which Robert, the admin officer, said hardly ever happens. 9 times out of 10, they just take the pods directly to the different projects. I'm hopeful we'll be able to open one soon. Tomorrow I actually get to do some work that doesn't involve monitoring vital signs. We're opening a pod for Dr. Isaacs and the Project Kitchen Knife. They said they need a specimen that is fully awake. These pods are filled with prisoners and drifters. They had their chance at a productive life and ruined it all. Yesterday was much harder than I imagined. When we opened the pod, the woman inside had no idea where she was. I'm aware that long-term stasis can cause disorientation, but she kept screaming for her husband, saying that they were on their way to a holiday in Europa. The doctor quickly sedated her and gave her a vocal cord numbing agent to stop the screaming. I mean, she was obviously lying about being a holidaymaker. These drifters will say anything to get out of this situation. We got another 2 products in this morning, transfers from a penal colony on Earth. I asked to have a look at their files, hoping that it would make this a little easier, but I was told that all records are sealed. I had to delete the last few logs. I read them over again, but they were just too painful. I can still hear the crying of the last man we thawed out. He didn't even scream. He sat on the bed crying until the doctor came in. They tagged him and took him down to the labs. He didn't even scream. Yesterday, we opened a pod with a 10-year-old boy in it. There must have been some sort of mistake, even if he was a drifter. He's a child. His name is Neil. He is in rehabilitation downstairs. I asked to go and visit him, but was told that it would be easier for me if I just let things be. I went out of product storage. I requested a transfer to the biomes. I think hydroponics will cheer me up. The pay isn't as good, but at least I'll be able to sleep at night. So, it sounds like to me, I have, like, a hair or something bothering my foot inside of my shoe. Sorry about that. But, it sounds like to me that people on the ship were fucking weird. I heard the department head talking about getting something for product storage. They already have 4 unopened stasis pods in the lab, but they're looking for a subject that can respond immediately. This isn't right. They're using projects from product storage too. I thought this was just a hydroponics bay. What the hell would they need human specimens for? Dara told me that there are more children in the rehabilitation centers under product storage. I'm going there tonight. These security lockdowns have been happening more frequently. I'm going to use them to my advantage. Tomorrow I'm going to get those kids out of here. I'm leaving these entries on the PDA so that if I disappear, you'll know what happened. Whoever's reading this, you need to help. Please help those children. I don't want to. I really don't want to. And this is locked, so you have to be like a level security something to get into there. But I really don't want to. I don't want to open those. Or I don't want to help them children, because they're not going to be children anymore. They're going to be fucking demons from hell. Or something. Noises, but yet elevator music still plays, because elevators don't know it's a horror game. Elevators just live their lives. Fucking, they don't care what's going on. They're just gonna give you musical tunes and make you feel better about your life while you're in them.
It's just getting colder.
We remind you that this is a non-smoking platform.